Once upon a time, on the outskirts of Beatty, Nevada, there was a small toad that was on its way to becoming endangered and made its way back. But this is a story that's bigger than that. It's a story about cooperation between man and the land and man and himself. But first, let's learn more about the Amargosa toad.
Threatened by habitat loss and non-native species, the Amargosa toad got a whole community behind its conservation cause. Indigenous to Oasis Valley, these little amphibians became a symbol of cooperation in the area.
This is Michael Burrows. He is a biologist, a wildlife biologist with the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service. Nice seeing you, sir.
Hi, John, good to see you.
Hey, thanks for joining me today.
Welcome, good to be here.
Tell me about the toad and how it got its name and what makes it different.
Well, it's got its name from where it's found here in the Amargosa River, Amargosa toad. And it's unique because this species of toad only occurs in this area.
The name Amargosa River comes from the Spanish word amargo, which means bitter. While the river's water is indeed quite alkaline, it's also the only place in the world you can find the Amargosa toad.
Give me some of their characteristics.
This toad is characterized by this what we call mid-dorsal stripe. There's a very light stripe going down the backbone. And then the other thing we look at are the what we call the parotid or paratoid glands, which are a defensive mechanism that excretes like an alkaloid substance as defense. And the shape and length and size of those is pretty unique to different species of toads.
Why do we care about this toad?
The Amargosa toad is a very unique species. It's found only here, and there are people that come here just to see the toad.
You know, that's amazing, isn't it? What we're looking at is only found. You want to see this, you got to come here. That's
right.
Amazing.
It is. It's just a 10-mile stretch of the Amargosa River and a few springs off the river, and that's it. That's the only place they're found. Very, very small distribution.
What would you say is the number one thing they need?
They need actual open water. And a lot of times what happens is vegetation will come and encroach upon the water and choke it out, and then the toads really can't use it anymore, and then they either have to go away or they disappear.
A species that needs open water living in one of the driest places on Earth? It's a precarious position, and for a while, the Amargosa toad was a candidate for the endangered species list.
They sure are cute. How are they doing today, numbers-wise?
They're doing very well. We, in partnership with many people in the community and other agencies, have been very, very successful and understanding what they need and providing that for them through habitat improvements and just monitoring the populations. We've been concerned about a disease that's been affecting a lot of amphibians worldwide, and the pathogen for that disease is here, but these animals don't seem to be affected by it, which is a really good thing.
Well, I know you've got your eye on the health of these things, and for that I thank you. And now I'm going to go check out the owner of this joint, see what role he played in helping this thing come back and thrive in its numbers.
Sounds good.
And I apologize in advance because I'm going to shake your hand with a slimy finger.
Sounds good.
One of the key players in helping the Amargosa toad population leap back to health is David Spicer, a rancher who owns some of the toad's habitats.
David, it is nice to see you, sir.
Nice to see you too, John. Glad you could make it today.
How many acres you got here?
320 on the base ranch.
Now tell me about the time that you met the toad.
The toad has been here forever. When we were kids growing up, we used to get the tadpoles out and raise them in the tank, and they turn into toads. They were in the yard. In 1993, there was a petition that was filed to list them as endangered.
The regulations triggered by the Endangered Species Act can be restrictive, so David and his fellow landowners were initially worried about the lawsuit.
My community was completely upside down when they had faced the ash meadows pupfish situation back in the 70s. That was the first enforcement act of endangered species that occurred.
This happened in the 70s, so 93 comes along, somebody files a lawsuit, and they're thinking, here we go again.
But in the midst of hostility, David opted for a different approach, cooperation.
We decided that we needed to create an opportunity to where we could have relationship for the government, a meaningful relationship instead of something that was confrontational. Well, we took a spring and redeveloped that spring, put running water back out there, created a habitat, and those toads begin to prosper, that broke all the walls down, because our result was a direct increase in the Amargosa toad population on this ranch.
And the result was not just in the population of the toad, but in the cooperation of all the agencies that got involved in this issue.
Who can argue with something that's obviously doing a good thing?
Mutual efforts prevented the Amargosa toad from being listed under the Endangered Species Act. The toad remains state protected and considered a species of special concern for federal agencies.
It's interesting because to sustain this and to improve upon what you've done for not only here and the toad and in Beatty, you've combined this with one of your personal passions.
I have. Personal passion of cycling, of mountain biking, road cycling. We live right next to Death Valley, some of the finest riding in the world.
So to boil it down, you've actually gone up on these hills with a shovel and created mountain biking trails.
We built these entirely by hand. Jackhammers, hand picks, shovels. We have 42 miles of trails here.
You are somebody who has helped break down a lot of walls, helped build up the environment, and it's been a pleasure spending time with you.
Well, thank you. I hope I can live up to that.
Yeah, you already have.
Thank you, John.
A success story, the Amargosa toad symbolizes the power of coming together for the common good of man and nature.
This is just a small segment of the mountain biking trail that David has cut into his land for the benefit of his entire community. And I think if there's one thing that this great Nevadan has shown us today, that the path of cooperation takes many twists and turns and they can get dusty. But if you see it through to the end, we'll all make it to the finish line.